Can you explain why Linux is not used more widely?
Installing Linux and managing it is not as easy as installing Windows.
Installing Windows is not easy, and it is hard to use compared to Apple.
Apple still uses the if in fault reboot, though it is usually a wipe and restart for the iPad.
That's a reason not to use Apple, not a reason to use Linux.
Linux comes in a lot of different flavors.
I've heard of Cinnamon versus Mint versus Ubuntu.
There are a lot of different versions of Linux, which makes it hard to switch between versions, much less maintain them.
It is hard enough shifting from Windows XP to Windows 7 or Windows 8. Having a dozen different versions of the operating system to work with is a hassle.
There are more than 50 different distributions of Linux, and each can be customized in terms of user interface and software on it.
No wonder they call Linux the operating system for hackers. You have to have system admin level powers to put all the apps you want on it.
Linux can run almost any operating system as an emulation and any type of software, though it takes work to put the necessary drivers and supporting programs on the system. The flexibility is good, but it takes work.
So you have to dedicate as much time as a system admin to run your PC.
You can get whole packages with everything from the operating system to free versions of Microsoft Office to video editing software pre-installed. There are even Linux versions with all the bioinformatics software installed.
I did not know you could get MS Office for free with Linux.
Actually, no, just applications that are like Microsoft Office.
Like Microsoft Office is not MS Office. And I do not want a hassle trying to read other people's files.
The greater challenge is sending them an almost Word document or not quite Excel spreadsheet and them being able to open it.
That's another reason not to use it.
And since Linux versions often have different video editing, picture editing, and sound editing applications, switching Linux versions often means having to relearn all the applications on the desktop too.
The learning curve would certainly slow down adoption of Linux. How then is Unix so common?
Unix has company-supported versions, and it has been a standard OS for enterprises since it was developed by AT&T.
Windows took off when it was adopted by IBM.
The difference is that Unix can still run on the server after an update without requiring a massive learning curve. Updating it and using it is far less painful than the differences between Windows versions, even Windows Server versions.
And what the system admin wants, the system admin gets.
And if the system admin says Unix is best to keep the company's servers up, they'll pay to maintain it. Unix at least has ultra-high reliability in its favor.
So does Linux.
True, but most people who already update Java and Adobe once a week and reboot do not need 99.99999% uptime, just fewer reboots. And you can do that with any non-Windows operating system.